He went to a Twin Cities high school, but 15 years later, he's been found dead in Syria.
And it's believed the man once known as Douglas McCain was fighting for the terror group ISIS. Fox 9's Maury Glover's back in our Fox 9 studio. Maury, you spoke with his cousin today. What did you find out?
Well, yeah, Kenyatta McCain says her cousin moved to San Diego a few years after high school, where he recently got married and had a child. Family members say he changed since converting to Islam about a decade ago, but he maintained his roots in Minnesota.
My reaction to it is that I know my cousin isn't a terrorist.
Kenyatta McCain can't believe the cousin she grew up with in Minnesota is gone.
He was always joking around, you know, doing stuff to make people happy, goofing off. That was his personality.
McCain says the State Department called her aunt on Monday to tell her they believe her son, Douglas, was killed over the weekend fighting for ISIS, the Islamic militant group responsible for beheading American journalist James Foley last week. The State Department telling family members McCain was identified by his passport and unique neck tattoo.
It had a lot to do with his beliefs that we all don't know about, you know, that he, the way he changed, you know, that we don't know about, if this is all true. Because the person we know is, this is not who he is, who he was.
Douglas attended Robbinsdale Cooper High School in the late 90s. You can see him in this class picture standing next to friend Troy Castigar, one of three Minnesotans shown in an Al-Shabaab recruitment video, who died while fighting in Somalia 2 years ago.
If you guys only knew how much fun we have over here, this is the real Disneyland.
According to McCain's Twitter page, he converted to Islam about 10 years ago, but became increasingly militant, saying in a recent post, "It's funny to me how all these so-called Muslims claim that they love Allah, but always curse the ones who try to implement his laws."
Very detached young guy.
Omar Jamal met McCain a couple of times at Minneapolis mosques and says at least 10 Minnesotans in the Somali community have been recruited to fight for ISIS in Syria.
Douglas McCain wasn't the first one, and unfortunately, he won't be the last.
But McCain says a militant Islamic fundamentalist isn't the man she knew or will remember.
That is not who my cousin was. He is not a terrorist.
Now, Kenyatta says Douglas communicated with her through Facebook just last Friday, and she heard from family members that he was in Turkey. Now she wonders if he is indeed dead, if his body will be returned to the U.S. to be buried.